Hello everyone. Today's lesson is a comprehension skill that is generalized or generalization. Alright, what's the meaning of generalization? A statement that is true. For many examples is a generalization. So when I make a statement and this statement, when I see it in other examples, I find it true. Then I can call it generalization. For example, here we have different types of birds. The first one, second, third, fourth, different types of birds. So they are all birds. This is number one. What do they have in common? All birds have wings. When we check the different birds, we find that's true. It's true for different kinds of birds. So we say all birds have wings. So I make this generalization because it is applicable or it is true for different types of birds. This skill we can also apply in reading, while reading our stories. So ideas in what you read are sometimes alike in several ways. So the first example we saw in pictures, it can also be applicable when it comes to ideas while you are reading your story. So sometimes they are alike, they are similar in several ways, in many ways. To generalize, you can make a general statement about them together. When you find that those ideas, they are the same, you can then make a generalization. When someone asks you, how did you find it? You say the different examples in which they are true. Look for clue words such as most, many, all, some, a few. Those will help you find the generalization. All right. Mammals are animals that need to breathe air. So number one, they breathe air. All mammals breathe air. This is one. Two, most mammals give birth to live babies. Okay, they give birth. This is number two. Mammal mothers also give milk to their babies. So here we have some pieces of information about mammals, some characteristics of mammals. Let me take the pen. Okay, so we have breathe air, give birth, and we have give milk or food or whatever, or nurse the babies. Okay, those are three ideas. We continue. Gray whales, those animals, whales, gray whales precisely, live in the ocean. All right. Mothers to be find a safe place, such as a lagoon, to give birth. Oh, so we have those mothers or those gray whales, they give birth. This is number one. After the calf is born, a female heifer pushes it up to the surface so it can breathe. So also gray whales, they breathe. They need air to breathe. Then the mother feeds the baby. So also here we have one, two, three. The same thing here. We have breathe air one, give birth two, and we are give milk three. Those are similar ideas. Here they are talking about mammals in general, whereas here they are talking about a specific type of animals. But first, how do we know whether it is a mammal or not? Anyway, let's come here. Directions. Are gray whales mammals? So, are those gray whales that we saw here, are they mammals that we find in the first paragraph? Yes or no? How can we generalize? Complete the chart, make a generalization. So this chart will help me. As we said before, generalization, when we make a statement that is true for many examples, then we call it generalization. So here we have examples, then we will see whether they are true or false. If they are all true, it means we can make a generalization. If not, then we cannot. Do gray whales breathe air? While we were reading, yes, where is it? It's number two, so it can breathe. So yeah, the breathe air. So we say yes. Example number two. Do gray whales give birth to babies? Yes, here is it. Give birth. Yes. Number three. Do gray whales nurse the young? It means do they feed them? Do they give them milk and food? Feeds the baby, yes. So we have yes. I think it is clear. Generalization. Gray whales are, of course, mammals. Gray whales are mammals. How did I know it? Because it is true for these different examples. Okay? Five. How did answering the questions, those questions from number one to number three, in the examples, help you make a generalization? So here, I would say, it helped me see how gray whales are mammals. All right. So for you, while you are reading a story, you have to pay attention to this one, and you have to try to elicit or to find some generalization. And of course, when you find them, you have to make sure whether they are true or not, and how? By finding different examples that are true about the same idea. I hope you enjoyed the lesson and you understand it. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to leave comments. I would be more than happy to answer you all. Have a lovely day and bye-bye.